Hash functions are very important for system security. Based on that, we can cipher messages and create some resume of contents and verify their integrity. And we can also share contents through the network with security, without having to transmit the real content in plain text. So let's take a look how we can use the Java programming language to see how to apply hash functions to cipher messages. So here we have the Java programming language, and we have the implementation of several hash functions. We can utilize in the Java programming the MessageDigest class, and it has implementation for many algorithms, such as MD5, which means MessageDigest 5, and SHA algorithms, which means secure hash algorithm. And one important thing when we create a hash content from a message is the size of the hash key. It can vary. For instance, SHA-512 has 512 bytes from the size of the key that's generated. And the same for another kind of functions. For instance, SHA-256, it has a key with the size. And so we are going to execute now one set of functions for create hash based in the same message. So we are going to cipher messages using MD5, using SHA-1, SHA-256, SHA-512. And there's also another version from SHA-3, then 256. So we are going to cipher the message using all these possibilities of hash keys and see the generated hash and evaluate their size. So let's execute this code here in our IDE. Just a moment, let me clear this output. Let me run this specific class. And here we have our output. Let's take a look here. So the message, when cryptographed by MD5, generated one hash size with 16 bytes. And the output, when presented in string manner, always double the size. For instance, here is 32. And why? Because here we are using 1 byte per character to be displayed. But actually, all these files are presented with 4 bits because they are hexadecimal values. So when we present it in the string manner, in the screen, the size double. However, internally in the byte type, it's half of the size. So just let's understand in the code, when we create the hash for one function, it always returns one hash object that is one array of bytes. Then when we are going to present that on the screen, we need to convert to string, and then it doubles the size because the programming language utilizes at least 1 byte per character. So here we can see that the MD5 uses 16 bytes to represent one hash. The SHA-1, 20 bytes. For instance, SHA-256, 32 bytes. SHA-500, 12, 64 bytes. So what we can see, how bigger the bytes, bigger is the key. Bigger is the key. And how more bigger, then more secure is the key, because when we try with string break the key, it's possible that biggest keys are harder to be broken as smaller keys. So when choosing the hash algorithm to cipher some message in our system, it is important to evaluate what is the necessary security, because then we can choose algorithms that produce bigger hashes, which would be harder for being broken for some kind of attack. So here we have examples of how to use Java programming language for creating hash from strings.